Hello, this is Ritola from Curbal.com, and I was asked last week if I could do a video about when to use Power BI versus when to use the Google Analytics web interface. So this is going to be a short video, but hopefully a useful one. Let's see, I'm basically using today Power BI for 95% of my analytics need when it comes to Google Analytics. But the reason for that is that I have a series of dashboards. So they have been created for the specific needs for that particular website. So depending on what the website is about, there are some certain goals that I want to follow, and I have made dashboards for that. That allows me to track and investigate easily. Like, for example, this idea web dashboard that you've seen before, that I can see what people search for on the site and give me ideas of new blog posts, for example, among other things. So you can do this, of course, in the Google Analytics web interface, without a doubt. But you will have to create that report. You can do custom reports in Google Analytics, but you don't have, or at least before, didn't have the possibility to create custom metrics. So I've I'm used to doing my own analysis with my own dashboards, and for that I use Power BI. Now, if something happens on the website, like you have a peak in traffic or a dip in traffic or a new referral, so whatever it is that is not normal, the dashboards that you might have in Power BI might not be optimal, if you would say so. So for that is when you would go to Google Analytics web interface here, and just you have all the metrics and information available, and you can do all types of cross-filtering. And that would be, I guess, the reason for using the Google Analytics interface. Another thing is that you can customize and have views in the admin. So here you have the different views for this website. Now, with Power BI, you can do these in Power Query. I think it's always useful to have these three views in the Google Analytics admin, which is a raw view, the filter view, and the test view. So I would do that always in the Explorer. And then you need to do some setup customizations if you want to, for example, to have these idea dashboard, you need to set up internal search, and the only way to do that is on the Google Analytics interface. So that would be the way to customize some things that you want to measure that do not come out of the box when you create a Google Analytics account. So it's more like a configuration of how your data should be stored and what should be stored. You do that in the Google Analytics interface. When it comes to anomalies on the data, I use an app which is called Quicklytics. It's only available in the App Store, so it's only available for iPhones or iPads. This is an excellent app. It just allows me to do all ad hoc analysis that I need, because I get all the dimensions and all the metrics almost all at least, and you can do cross filter. So if you have an iPhone, I really recommend you download this. This is a fantastic app. It costs not sure, like €4 or €5, something like that. So it's cheap for the functionality you get. It's absolutely cheap, and I'm not affiliated in any way with this developer. But his app is absolutely great. Another thing that you would use the Google Analytics web interface is for the filters, the spam filters. But for that, I'm using, I've shown you before, the Referrum spam blocker. And what it does is you give them access to the administrative API, if we call it like that. So what it does is it goes into your Google Analytics account and set the filters by itself. So you don't actually need to go into the Google interface anymore. So for me, I use my reports in Power BI, and then I use Quicklytics. That's all I do for analysis. And then if I want to set up something new or a new functionality comes in Google Analytics that I need to set up in the admin, I would do it on the interface. But otherwise, I don't use it at all. If you cannot have these on your mobile, then I recommend to use the Google Analytics web interface for all these kind of anomalies in your data, peaks and dips and new things happening, so to say, that you might not be able to analyze here. So I hope this video was useful and you better understand the differences between the Power BI and the web interface functionality, you would say. So if you like the video, please let me know. And if you have any questions or you would like to suggest a video, let me know also in the comment box. Subscribe. I publish a video a week on different things. Have a nice day.